Minister Gilmore Hoefdraad van Financiën heeft de nieuwe vertegenwoordiger van de Inter-Amerikaanse Ontwikkelingsbank, IDB, voor Suriname verwelkomd. De IDB-vertegenwoordiger Antonio Gonsalves heeft op 28 januari 2020 een werkbespreking gevoerd met de minister, waarbij lopende projecten als ook toekomstplannen zijn besproken. In het volgende gesprek praat de vertegenwoordiger over de samenwerking met Suriname en de vooruitzichten.
The relationship, like I said before, is a long relationship. I expect this to grow. Suriname is a owner of the IDB. It's a member country owner of the IDB, and it's in. In our interest, both of our interests, to increase that relationship, to help the Surinamese, to help the improve the life of the Surinamese people in the different sectors that we are. So we are here to support, to provide technical expertise, advice in any areas that the minister would like us to participate, but always with the aim to improve the lives of the Surinamese people.
We are looking back with Ms. Sandra as permanent secretary, who has been involved with all these projects from 2010 on, on a fruitful relationship with you. We always have had excellent relationship with all the representatives of the ADB here, and we are looking forward actually to the same relationship with you. I have an open house. I'm always available, not always at these gentle hours. But I think everybody told you that I'm always 24/7 on the job. But I know that you're willing and ready for us, so we start the engagement from now on.
Absolutely. Right now we have a portfolio in different areas, in health, in education, in transportation, in energy, in the recuperation of all downtown. We are financing the construction of the Congress building, and all these projects are going to continue. Also in Vesur, which is a loan that we're just going to sign at the pre-annual meeting in Barbados, where the minister is going to go next February. So we are in about 9 sectors in the country operating, and there are new ideas. We need to prepare, you know, what's happening with the oil, how we can help Suriname to take advantage of this opportunity, historical opportunity, to the benefit, again, of the Surinamese people. So every time a country finds a natural resource, it creates all this excitement, right? Especially when the idea is, you know, we have all this amount of resources for a population. I think what a responsible person have to ask is, okay, now I have this opportunity, how am I going to use these resources in order that they're not wasted? No, it's an opportunity, a historic opportunity for Suriname, so it has to be used so that it lasts long, it's for the benefit of most of the Surinamese, and it creates a better economy, it provides a better life for the Surinamese. And so to us, it's an exciting moment to provide examples on other countries, how they have dealt with it, ideas. Of course, the decision is always for the people of Suriname and the government of Suriname to decide. But we can provide examples. This has happened here. This is a lesson learned. Do this, do that, so that they can have an educated decision as to what to do. I think it's exciting until the benefits of the oil are received. It's going to be another 3-4 years because you need a lot of investment until you extract it, but it gives enough time to think, what are we going to do with it? How can we help our people in the long run and make Suriname a better country?